squeaky chair. This chair squeaks too much. I've given you the worst, now I'm here to give you the best. It's the top 10 best 2011 films I saw in 2011, with honorable mentions. And like I said in my worst of video, which is something you should really check out, I wasn't able to see every 2011 release, and in this case, I didn't really see much after September, which means I haven't really seen too many award-winning movies, I haven't really seen the critically acclaimed ones, I haven't seen War Horse, I haven't seen The Artist, The Descendants, Shame. Been watching a little bit of porn, which is, well, like Shame, but it's not the same. Not the same. And one more time, since I love to shamelessly plug my own shit, that does not sound right. You can check out my longest video that I did, where I read off every single 2011 release that I saw, or you can click on the link down below, which will direct you to my Facebook page, where I posted the list of every single movie that I saw in 2011. Every 2011 release. Now, the movies that I have on this list are my opinion, and you have to understand, when I go to the movies, I like to be entertained, or I like to feel something, and usually I want to feel good, not confused or depressed. But this is my list, my opinion. Please respect that. Let's get on with this. Real quick, some honorable mentions. 13 Assassins, which is a Japanese samurai epic, and it is so damn good. I would have actually had this movie on my list had it not technically been a 2010 movie. But it was released in 2011, and of course that's when I saw it. But because I'm so technical, it's not on this list. The Adventures of Tintin, which is just so adventurous and so much fun, and it looked great. Fast 5, which we all know was one awesome-ass action movie. Didn't matter how illogical it was. Henna, which was a great, unique action thriller, and I dug it. Insidious, which I know a lot of people didn't really care for, and some people did. It's an honorable mention because it's a horror movie that actually creeped the shit out of me, and horror movies do not normally do that. Midnight in Paris. Why? Because it's a Woody Allen movie that I actually liked. Rise of the Apes, which I hate calling it by its full title. And yes, I am going to show off the movies that I do own. Why? Because I'm a show off. I actually do own Fast 5, but my friend is actually borrowing it. And Thor, which might be underwhelming as an action movie, but I really loved the story. Okay, now on to the top 10. Number 10 for me was just a really wonderful drama, very emotional, with a brilliant ensemble cast, and definitely something that should get some Oscar recognition. And that's The Help. This movie is just right. It's not over dramatic, it's not corny, it doesn't overdo it. It's got awesome dialogue, it's very funny, very emotional. Viola Davis was exceptional. She really must get an Oscar nod for this. Emma Stone did a great job. The whole cast was amazing. Number 9 is Crazy Stupid Love, and I could not believe how much I loved this movie. It was extremely funny. It actually had some really good drama in it. Steve Carell was terrific. Julianne Moore, which, I mean, she's just so hot for her age. She was good. Emma Stone was really good. Oh, crap. 2 Emma Stone movies are on my top 10. Nice. But Ryan freaking Gosling, because of his role in this movie, I can officially say I am a fan. I know everybody loves him in that movie where he sits behind the steering wheel and then he stares at people awkwardly. But his role in Crazy Stupid Love was amazing. He's a fast talker, a real charmer. I'm not a gay man, but whew, Ryan Gosling? Okay, I'm just gonna stop now. Number 8, and I swear to you, I did not put this at number 8 on purpose. Well, I put it on purpose because that's just where it ranked. But I didn't actually... Okay, Super 8. It's so true that when you watch this movie, you get the nostalgic feeling. You definitely get the Steven Spielberg vibe. But the cast of kids is terrific. It's a really funny movie. It's got great drama in it. The special effects are terrific. The score is terrific. I didn't think all the secrecy behind this movie was really that warranted, but it does add something great when you actually do see the movie. It's not a perfect movie, but it's a damn good one. And number 7 is X-Men First Class. This movie definitely put the X-Men franchise back on track. It's fast-paced. The visual effects are terrific. There's plenty of action. There's some good storytelling. You definitely get that vintage vibe because it takes place in the 60s. But definitely the best element in this movie is the bromance between Xavier and Eric Lyncher, the man who will become Magneto. Michael Fassbender just completely steals the show. Yeah, James McAvoy was terrific as Xavier, but Fassbender, that fool was a star. Okay, number 6 is a movie that really caught me off guard. It's Arthur Christmas. I really had no idea what to expect from this movie. I didn't even want to see it until I knew it was written and created by the guys that did Chicken Run and Wallace and Gromit, the movie they did, Curse of the Something Rabbit. I should know this. It's like one of my favorite movies. And you can definitely tell because this movie has some very sharp, witty dialogue. It's extremely funny, has a great little twist, or should I say spin on everything we know about Santa Claus. The voice work is terrific, the animation was good. Grand Santa is one of the best characters in animated history. He's hilarious. It's actually very heartfelt, it's very smart, and it's kind of a shame that it's a Christmas movie. I kind of have this thing where I can't really watch Christmas movies unless it's Christmas time, because the movie is seriously funny enough to actually watch any time of the year. Number 5 is a movie I was hoping would be good, and it turned out to be great. And it's yet another great animated movie, Polar Panda with Kung Fu Panda 2. To me, this film is like what The Dark Knight was to Batman Begins. A 5-star sequel to an already 5-star original. In many ways, this is much better than the first one. It actually has a better story, more action, the animation is more perfected, it's funny, and it actually gives some really good backstory on Polar Panda. It's gorgeous to look at, it's highly entertaining, and it's definitely fun for all ages. Number 4 is an awesome movie, Believe. Number 4 is Attack the Block. Here's a movie that could have been a complete disaster. It was shot with a low budget, it has a zero known cast except for Nick Frost. What the hell happened there? And it's yet another alien invasion movie, yet this movie is fresh, it's fun, it's hip. There really was a lot of fun. I had so much fun with this movie. A lot of people don't like the characters because they're a bunch of lowlives. But to me, I understood why they're lowlives. That's their lifestyle. They're a bunch of punks and hoodlums and hooligans and little fuckers. But yet they have to step it up. They have to become men to fight these aliens. And that's where the fun begins. The movie has some great gore effects. A terrific soundtrack. It is so much fun. It's slightly underrated. More people should really check it out. Number 3. Dun, 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 dun. Mission Impossible. Ow! Mission Impossible Ghost Protocol. This movie was everything I hoped for. This is exactly what I needed at the end of the year. Except for Fast 5, 2011 didn't really have too many memorable action movies. So being able to see Mission Impossible at the end of the year was a real thrill ride for me, and it was a complete treat. And the fact that I saw it in IMAX, and it was truly one of the best experiences I've had in my life in a movie-going aspect. Tom Cruise was terrific and a great leader in this movie, but for the first time, the supporting cast really gets to shine. Paula Payton, who's just too hot for words, she was a complete badass. Simon Pegg was terrific, he was funny. Jeremy Renner was great. I mean, Jeremy Renner is... There's a reason why he's gonna be the next Bourne. The movie was so much fun, it wasn't too complicated, it was just right. And by far the best one in the series. Number 2 is a movie I have no problem admitting that I cried to. And that's 50-50, a hilarious tearjerker. Such a great emotional story. It's so funny and yet so sad at the same time. I can relate to the movie because I've been around people who've had cancer. It's just such a brilliantly written movie, so wonderfully acted. Joseph Gordon-Levitt needs an Oscar nomination. Seth Rogen was a terrific supporting character. Anna Kendrick, oh my god, I love her, she's so adorable. There are some great relationships in this movie. It truly is a must-see. And my favorite, number 1 film of 2011, I'm just gonna get right into it. It's Battle Los Angeles. The intensity, the emotion, the action, the character development. If you believe this is my number 1 pick for 2011, you're full of shit. No, the number 1 film of 2011 in my opinion, and it's a complete shock to me. A film I would have never imagined I would actually put on my top spot for this year. And to be quite honest, I didn't want to put it on my top spot. But it's absolutely one of the greatest finales in film history, and of course I'm talking about Harry Potter, how's your father? Oh, that's right, he's already dead. Harry Potter and the Deathly Hallows Part 2. The reason why I'm shocked that this is number 1 and the reason why I didn't want to have to put it as number 1 was the fact that it is technically the other half of a movie. And I wasn't exactly the biggest fan of the series. I really did not get truly invested with it until part 5, which was The Order of the Phoenix. But since then, I was truly hooked on this series. I knew it was leading up to something great, and this movie was great. I've never read the book, so I've heard the complaints that people have made saying that they didn't put this, they didn't put that. But with me just judging the movie, I was truly and thoroughly satisfied. I thought it had the right level of emotion. It had the most epic wizard battles I've ever seen. The special effects were terrific. The score, the cinematography, the the actors have really stepped up to become great in this film. The secrets that are revealed in this movie, the seeing this come to a close was truly a magical event. I've seen this movie about 5 times already, and I'm invested every single time I watch it. I actually felt emotional when it ended, but I was also very pleased, and it is my number one film of 2011. So that's it. Those are my top favorite films. This list is legit, it is official, but it's only for the films that I saw in 2011. What I might do, and this is actually the idea of another YouTuber, I don't know if he's gonna do it or not, is when I actually catch up with some of the award-winning movies, the acclaimed movies, I might make a reformatted list if any of those movies truly do impress me. So overall, 2011 was a satisfying year. I'm not gonna say it was a great year, because it really didn't give me a whole lot to truly be amazed with. Hopefully, 2012 will be even better. And I'm just gonna stop now before I start rambling. What?